Dr. Veena, today's topic is isoenzymes and clinical enzymology. Now, what are isoenzymes? Isoenzymes are multiple molecular forms of same enzyme. The different isoenzyme catalyze the same chemical reaction. Okay, so they are multiple molecular forms. They are different in their structure, but they catalyze the same chemical reaction. But they differ in the primary structure and the kinetic property. So the definition is they are multiple molecular forms of an enzyme having same catalytic activity or physically distinct forms of the same enzyme. So they are physically distinct and catalyzing the same enzyme activity. Different molecular forms of the same enzyme enzymes are synthesized from various tissues. Hence, they are useful to understand the diseases of different organs. So, these isoenzymes are synthesized from the various tissues, sometimes from liver, sometimes from brain, or sometimes from heart, like that. So, we can understand the disease of different organs by estimating the different isoenzymes. Now, isoenzymes differ in their physical and chemical property, that is the kinetic properties. Like structure, they have different chemical structure, electrophoretic property, that is mobility in the electrophoretic field may be different for different isoenzymes. Example, lactate dehydrogenase, creatine kinase and alkaline phosphatase. Then immunological property also may be different for different isoenzymes. Then Km value and Vmax values also may be different. Examples are glucokinase and hexokinase. And you know that all enzymes have an optimum pH at which the maximum activity. So the optimum pH of isoenzyme also may be different. And their susceptibility to inhibitors also may be different. And then the degree of denaturation, you know, all the enzymes are proteins and they may be denatured by heat. So heat stability is another different properties by which we can identify the isoenzyme. Then the site of production, they may be produced from different tissues like brain, heart, liver, etc. Then cofactor requirement, you know, that enzymes require cofactor like coenzymes in various reactions. So each isoenzyme have a different cofactor sometimes. So these are the kinetic, physical and chemical properties by which isoenzymes get differed. Now, isoenzyme may be formed when they are made up of different subunits, that is hybrid isoenzyme. All enzymes do not have isoenzyme. Remember, all enzymes do not have isoenzyme. Certain enzymes only have the isoenzyme when there are different subunits. So the subunits may be either a product of a single gene, then the subunits are the same, known as homomultimer. If they are produced from a different genes, subunits may be different, and then they are called the heteromultiple. So the isoenzyme may be a homomultimer where the subunits are all the same type. That is, they are produced from the single gene. Heteromultimers, the subunits may be different because they are produced from the different genes. In this picture, you can see a product of different gene producing different polypeptides. And from the polypeptides, when they are assembling in various forms, they may produce different type of isoenzyme. Here you can see possible isomer A gene and B gene. A gene produces mRNA, B gene again produces a type of mRNA which may coat and produces polypeptide, and one subunits of A gene is M subunits, but B gene subunits is B. So M and B can have various combinations like MM, MB and BB. So the creatine kinase is an example of this type. It is a dimer. That is, dimer means it is having two subunits. So the various combinations are MM, MB and BB. So these are the three isoenzymes of creatine kinase. Similarly, if the product of genes are either H or M, we can have a combination of tetramer for LDH, lactate dehydrogenase, where you can see various combinations. That is, when there are 4H subunits, they are the LDH1, then 3H and 1M, that is LDH2, and 2H and 2M subunits, where it is LDH3, and 1H and 3M, that is LDH4, and all the four subunits, if they are of M type, then they are LDH5. So it is a tetrameric form. The lactate dehydrogenase is a tetrameric form produced from two separate genes and two subunits arranged in various four combinations of four. That is tetramer having four subunits. So they can be arranged in various ratio. That is five isoenzymes can be formed. So that we'll deal later. Okay. Now, how will you identify the different isoenzymes? There are various methods for identification of these isoenzymes. That is, one is electrophoresis, then heat stability. We have already discussed various isoenzymes having various heat stability. So, by looking at that, we can identify the enzyme. Then, depending upon the various inhibitors, certain isoenzymes can be identified. And cofactor, here you can see mitochondrial isocitrate dehydrogenase is an NAD dependent and cytoplasmic isocitrate dehydrogenase is an NADP dependent. So, by looking at this cofactor requirement, we can identify the isoenzyme. Then, phi is the localization, that is, if isoenzyme LDH1 is there, we can make that it is from the heart, and LDH4, M4 is there, and if it is LDH5. So like that, depending upon the localization of the production of these subunits, we can make out the or identify the isoenzymes. Another method is by specific antibodies. Creatine kinase are separated by specific antibodies. Similarly, KM value and the substrate specificity, that a glucokinase and hexokinase can be identified. That is, you have studied in glycolysis, glucokinase and hexokinase catalyze the same reaction, but they have got separate affinity towards the substrate glucose. So, depending upon the low affinity, will have a more KM, like that you can identify the enzyme. Now first we'll pass on to the typical example of an isoenzyme, lactate dehydrogenase. Lactate dehydrogenase is a tetrameric enzyme that catalyzes the oxidation of lactate to pyruvate, and it has five isoenzymes and made up of two polypeptide, that is M from muscle and H from heart. Since the LDH is a tetramer, there are five combinations possible with varying ratio, and two kinds of polypeptides are present. So here you can see the reaction, lactate is oxidation to pyruvate, where the NAD is the coenzyme. So LDH is interconverted lactate to pyruvate, normal values 100 to 200 international units per liter. LDH is a tetramer, has five isoenzyme. Isoforms can be separated by electrophoresis. Subunits are H from heart and M from muscle, a polypeptide, and they are produced from two different genes. All forms are seen in all persons. So in this table, you can see various forms of LDH1, 2, 3, etc., and their subunits. LDH1 is H4 and it is fastest moving at electrophoresis at pH 8.6, and activity at 60 degrees centigrade at 430 minutes is not destroyed, that it is heat stable. And then tissue of origin is heart, and the percentage is 30% of the total LDH is by LDH1. So like that, LDH2 is H3M1, faster, not destroyed by heat. It is present in RBC. 35% of total LDH is constituted by the LDH2. Then LDH3, M2, H2M2, fast moving, partially destroyed by heat. It is produced from brain and 20%. LDH4, H1, M3, slow moving in the electrophoresis. It is heat labile, that is, it is destroyed by heat and produced from the liver and 10%. LDH5, M4, slowest moving, and it is heat labile and destroyed by heat, and it is produced from the skeletal muscles, liver, and only 5% of the total. So this is how the isoenzyme pattern occurs for the LDH or lactate dehydrogenase. So here you can see a picture of electrophoresis. The fastest moving is the H4 and the slowest moving is the M4, in between H3M1, H2M2, HMM3, like that. Then upper values are seen in children. Normal values 100 to 200 international units. Upper values seen in children. Severe exercise, there is a slight increase. Values increases 100 times more inside the RBC than in the plasma. Therefore, hemolysis will increase the normal value and give false positive value. So it is usually plenty in RBC. So the hemolysis will affect the value. What are the clinical significance of lactate dehydrogenase? Lactate dehydrogenase released into the blood in myocardial infarction, liver disease, etc. And myocardial infarction, the H4 isoenzyme increased 5 to 10 times. You have seen that H4 is from the heart. So in myocardial infarction, where there is heart attack, heart muscles are destroyed or infarcted, then the enzyme will be released. So 5 to 10 times more level of enzyme will be seen in the serum. Then LDH will be more than 1500 units per liter in acute myocardial infarction. That shows a grave prognosis, a bad prognosis. Suppose a patient had an heart attack and the LDH value is more than 1500 units, then you can make sure that it's an acute onset, sudden onset of myocardial infarction, which is having a bad prognosis. Other differential diagnoses are hemolytic anemia, because it is also produced from the RBC, and hepatocellular damage, because it is also produced from liver, muscular dystrophy, carcinomas, leukemias, and any disease where the cell necrosis occurs. LDH is produced from various tissues, so it will increase in various diseases. So it is not specific for a particular thing, but certain isoenzymes are useful for the diagnosis of certain disease. Now we will pass on to the isoenzymes of creatine kinase. Creatine kinase, there is a transference of energy in muscle metabolism. Here, creatine kinase catalyzes the reversible phosphorylation of creatine to creatine phosphate by using ATP. Creatine kinase activity greater in striated muscle, brain, and heart muscle. So you can see CK, creatine is converted to creatine phosphate by the creatine kinase enzyme, where ATP is used and ADP and PI is produced. The tissue of sources are skeletal muscle, heart muscle, and brain. CK normal value 15 to 100 units per liter in males and 10 to 80 units per liter in females. CKMB, that is the second fraction, that is from the heart, it is less than 6% of the total value. So CK is a dimer. Subunits are from brain and muscle, B for brain and M for muscle. And their mobility, CKMM is the CK3, which is the least movable thing in electrophoresis, and it is from the skeletal muscle, and 80% of the total CK is by the CKMM or CK3. And CKMB or CK2 is intermediate mobility in the electrophoresis, and it is produced from the heart muscles and only constitute 5% of the total creatine kinase. CKBB or the CK1 is the fastest moving isoenzymes of creatine kinase. It is tissue of origin is the brain, and it is only 1% of the total CK. So if you are asked to write about the isoenzyme pattern, you can write two examples. So one is LDH, which is a tetramer having 5 isoenzymes. And second one is the CK, which is a dimer having 3 isoenzymes. What are the clinical significance of CK? That is myocardial infarction. It is very important for the diagnostic purpose, mainly the CKMB. It starts to increase within 3 hours of myocardial infarction, reaches to maximum between 2 to 3 days and comes to normal within 3 to 4 days. Useful to detect the early cases of myocardial infarction. So immediately after chest pain, suppose the patient is having myocardial infarction, 3 hours after the pain, if you are testing the blood for the CKMB, if the level is increased, you can make sure that he is suffering from myocardial infarction or heart attack. CK not increase in hemolysis or congestive cardiac failure, that is an advantage to the LDH. The LDH1 also can be increased in myocardial infarction, but it has got a disadvantage that it will be value may be affected by hemolysis, because total LDH will be very high in RBC. So suppose there is hemolysis in this heart attack patient, then there will be a confusion. So CK increase more than 8 times shows a bad prognosis. Just like LDH more than 1500 units, it's a bad prognosis. Here creatine kinase, if its value increases more than 8 times of the normal value, that shows a bad prognosis. It is very bad condition. So in this graph you can see various enzyme pattern, that is enzyme level and the onset of days at the production, that is creatine kinase. It is also known as creatine phosphokinase. Start increasing by 3 hours and maximum level it is going, and then it is coming down. The next is the LDH. We have studied slowly increasing and it is going down. So first enzyme increased is CKMB, and helpful for detection of early myocardial infarction. CKMB detection is important in myocardial infarction. So compared to LDH, CKMB is very useful because early onset of increase in the blood. And then there is one more application for creatine kinase, that is in muscle disease. Creatine kinase is very much, that is 500 to 1500 increase in seen in the muscular dystrophy, that is total CK, not the CKMB. CK, creatine kinase highly increase in crush injuries, bone fractures and acute coronary vascular accidents. That is when there is road traffic accident or when there is muscular injury due to fall or accident, then sudden rise of creatine kinase total level will be seen. That is about 500 to 1500 units. That is the total CK, that is mainly from the muscles, skeletal muscles. The estimation of total CK, so it is important in muscular disease, and CKMB isoenzyme estimation is important in myocardial infarction. That you have to study well. That is, estimation of total CK contains mainly of the muscle, because 80% is from the muscle. So that will be reflecting there. Then CKMB alone, if you are estimating, if it is elevated, you can make sure that condition is myocardial infarction. So this is the diagram where you can easily find out the various isoenzymes. CK1, that is from the brain. BB is the subunits. CK2 is the BMB, that is from the myocardium or heart. CK3 is the MM, from the skeletal muscle. So CK1 is the brain, CKMB is myocardium, CK3 is of skeletal muscle. Now, what are the clinical various clinical application of isoenzyme? You have to know what is a functional plasma enzyme and non-functional. Functional plasma enzymes having some function, specific function in the plasma. they are having a specific function in the blood, that is called the functional plasma enzyme or plasma specific enzymes. So examples are lipoprotein lipase, proenzymes of blood coagulation. So you have to have always the blood coagulation enzymes in your blood, that is in the proenzyme form. Whenever you are getting an injury, the blood has to be clotted immediately. So that will be present in the plus plasma always. That is the meaning of functional plasma enzyme. Their level in the tissue or cell will be less than that of a plasma. Non-functional plasma enzymes are elevated in the cell death or disease. They are mainly present in the cells, and when the cell death or cell necrosis occurs, they will be released into the blood, and that is the non-functional plasma enzyme. So in this picture you can see the non-functional plasma enzyme. The cell contains the enzyme, plenty enzyme concentration is more in the cell and very much less in the plasma. But during necrosis, as a result of the disease or trauma, from the cells, these enzymes will be released into the blood plasma, and the level of the plasma, level of the enzyme in the plasma is very much increased. So if you estimate the level in this, you can make out the tissue of damage. Now, what are the biomarkers? Biomarkers are clinical laboratory tests which is useful for detecting or the dysfunction of an organ. Suppose an organ is destroyed or dysfunction, that is due to myocardial infarction, heart muscle is infarcted, or death of the heart muscle cells occurs. So in this condition, there are some clinical laboratory tests by which you can identify the disease. So cardiac biomarkers are used to detect the cardiac disease, like acute coronary syndrome due to myocardial infarction or congestive cardiac failure due to ventricular dysfunction. These are the two common conditions where the cardiac biomarkers are very helpful. That is acute myocardial infarction, sudden heart attack, and congestive cardiac failure due to the dysfunction of the cardiac ventricle. Now, important cardiac markers are enzymes like creatine kinase that we have already discussed. It is a dimer having 3 isoenzymes. CKMB, the second CK2, is the cardiac isoenzyme which is used as the cardiac biomarker. Then there are cardiac troponins T and I. That is not an enzyme, but it is useful as a cardiac biomarker. Then aspartate aminotransferase, that is another enzyme that also can be used as a cardiac biomarker. Lactate dehydrogenase, we have discussed. H4 fraction, that is LDH1, is from the heart. If its level is increased in myocardial infarction, then you can make sure that it is due to the heart attack. Then there are other important brain natriuretic peptides and myoglobin, which are of not enzymes but can be used as a biomarkers. Now we'll pass on to the aspartate aminotransferase or serum glutamate oxalate transferase. Here the reaction they catalyze is aspartate plus alpha ketoglutarate converted to oxaloacetate and glutamate. The tissue or source is cardiac muscle, liver and skeletal muscle, in lesser extent kidney, pancreas and RBC. Normal serum levels are 8 to 20 units per liter. So AST level will be elevated in acute myocardial infarction and also in liver disease, hepatocellular disease like hepatoma, viral hepatitis, skeletal muscle disease and pulmonary embolism. So various tissues produces AST, so their level may be elevated in all these conditions. That is why it is not specific for cardiac alone, but along with the CKMB, if AST also is elevated, you can say that it is due to the myocardial infarction. So AST will be elevated in acute myocardial infarction. In acute myocardial infarction, AST level rises within 12 hours. That is not immediately, only after 12 hours. Peak level of AST 24 hours and return to normal after 5 days. So it is of not much importance nowadays, because we are using this isoenzyme CKMB and cardiac troponin for the immediate diagnosis. Due to wide tissue distribution, AST is not useful in diagnosing myocardial infarction. So it is produced from various tissues like liver, etc. So it is not a specific biomarker for the cardiac disease. You can see in this graph, increase within first 12 hours, peak in 24 hours. Normally, it touches the normal by the 3 to 5 days. Now, other markers, prostatic markers, acid phosphatase secreted by the prostatic cell, hydrolyzed phosphatic ester at pH 4 and 6, normal range 2.5 to 12. It is increased values are seen in prostatic cancer. High levels elevation is seen in bone secondaries. It is useful to assess the prognosis of cancer. So prostatic markers are acid phosphatase, that is hydrolyzes the phosphatic ester, and its level will be increased in prostatic cancer. So prostatic acid phosphatase level will be increased in prostatic cancer. Another prostatic marker is the prostatic specific antigen secreted by the secretory epithelium of the prostate gland to the seminal fluid. So normal range is 1 to 5 micrograms per liter, very specific for prostate, value more than 10 micrograms per liter, indicative of cancer. So these two are the prostatic biomarkers, acid phosphatase and prostatic specific antigen. Now, what is amylase? It is secreted from pancreas and salivary gland, and normal range 50 to 120 in units per liter. Value increases 100 times in acute pancreatitis. Moderate increase is seen in mumps, chronic pancreatitis. So amylase level will be increased in acute pancreatitis. It is a marker of acute pancreatitis. Similarly, lipase enzyme present in the pancreatic secretion, normal range is less than 40 units per liter. Elevated in acute pancreatitis, not elevated in mumps. So advantages over the amylase estimation. So if you are having lipase increased, amylase normal, you can make sure that it is due to acute pancreatitis. Moderate elevation in carcinoma, pancreas and biliary disease are seen. Next enzyme is glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase. It's an important enzyme in HMB shunt pathway. You know, glucose to glucose-6-phosphate, then it is converted to 6-phosphogluconate, where NADP is converted to NADPH. This NADPH is going to for the reduction of oxidized glutathione to reduced glutathione in the RBC. So, and used NADPH production occurs in these reactions. Normal value, glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase in RBC, 125 to 250 units per 10 raised to 12 cells or 6 to 12 units per gram of hemoglobin. Role of glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase in RBC metabolism, usually there will be production of superoxide anions in the RBC, that is free radicals. So that has to be scavenged or removed by the glutathione peroxidase, which needs reduced glutathione so that it is converted to oxidized. By the time hydrogen peroxide, which is produced from the superoxide anion, is converted to water so that it is non-toxic. So for the conversion of reduced oxidized glutathione to reduced glutathione, we need NADPH. NADPH is converted to NADP. NADP again is producing NADPH by the G6PD enzyme. So here we require glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase for the complete reaction where the free radicals are removed. So suppose H2O2 formed in the RBC, thus prevented by NADPH and glutathione. The NADPH maintain the RBC membrane integrity. So in what happens in deficiency is, in glucose-6-phosphate deficient individual, RBC lifespan is reduced, but no disease manifestation. When such person take some drugs like which will induce hemolysis in RBC, then it will cause hemolytic anemia. The drugs usually produces or induces hemolysis are aspirin, mepacrin, primaquine and sulfur. That is anti-malarial plus anti-inflammatory drug. When you are given to a person who is having glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency, that will induces hemolysis because there is no production of NADPH. And then if there is no NADPH, the free radicals produced in the RBC will not be removed. So that will produce harmful effect to the RBC, and the RBC membrane will be lysed or broken, and hemolytic anemia occurs. Similarly, methemoglobinemia also is produced when there is deficiency. So in the body, methemoglobin is converted to normal hemoglobin by the methemoglobin reductase enzyme, which requires NADPH. So in the G6PD deficiency, if there is decreased production of NADPH, methemoglobin level increases in the blood, producing methemoglobinemia. So here you can see various disease and enzyme assay: myocardial infarction, CKMB, AST and LDH. Liver disease, ALT, AST, ALP, gamma GT and nucleotide phosphatase. Gastrointestinal disorder, amylase and lipase. Muscle disease, creatine kinase, aldolase. Bone disease, ALP. Now what is therapeutic enzyme? You know, some enzymes can be used for the treatment of certain diseases. Examples: asparaginase enzyme can be used for the lymphoblastic leukemia. Then streptokinase can use to dissolve the intravascular clot in myocardial infarction. Similarly, urokinase also can be used to dissolve the intravascular clot. Pancreatin is an enzyme which uses which can be used in pancreatic insufficiency. And pepane, it is acting as an anti-inflammatory agent. It is also an enzyme. Then alpha-1 antitrypsin can be used in alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency, that is emphysema. There are some enzymes used for the diagnostic purpose. What are they? That is for the use of certain estimation of certain enzyme. Urease can be used for the testing urea level. Uricase for uric acid level. Glucose oxidase can be used for the estimation of glucose. Peroxidase for the glucose, as well as glucose oxidase and peroxidase for glucose and cholesterol. It is for the cholesterol also. Then lipases for the estimation of triglyceride. Horseradish peroxidase and alkaline phosphatase can be used as a mark for labeling the enzyme-linked sorbent assay, immunosorbent assay, that is ELISA technique. So these two enzymes are important for doing ELISA. Then restriction endonuclease, southern blotting. Reverse transcriptase enzyme can be used in RT-PCR. So these are the enzyme used in diagnosis of or used for the testing, in the lab testing of various estimation. But main importance is the therapeutic enzyme which are used for the treatment. So now we finished isoenzymes and clinical enzymology, of which we are mainly dealt with the two isoenzymes, LDH and creatine kinase, lactate dehydrogenase and creatine kinase, and the cardiac biomarkers that is mainly used is the CKMB, AST and the lactate dehydrogenase. And we have discussed also about the certain biomarkers like pancreas, and then glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase, and also about the therapeutic enzymes, where the enzymes are used for the treatment of disorders like myocardial infarction, streptokinase, and then asparaginase for the lymphoblastic leukemia. Thank you.